Welcome back to Ultimate Skyrim, my friends. This is Season 1, Episode 40, the Big 4-0. So last we left off, you guys know what happened in the last episode. It was a harrowing experience, a harrowing dragon escape. We lost our love, Ingrid. Let me be the first to introduce you to Cinnamon, our new friend, who is wearing Ingrid's old armor. So, you know, in a sense, her spirit lives on. And her spirit lives on in all of us as well. We're living in a different world now than the world we lived in before the dragon attack. It's really changed everything. I've been thinking a lot about it, about, you know, kind of the direction that our character will be going in and what kind of Hjolfrid's parsing of this situation has been. And I think that we're looking at a much more sober character here. You know, I think that the gravity of the situation is really setting in. What do we know? I think we know, so here, first of all, in fact here, I'm gonna go walk over to that Khajiit caravan and see if they have anything useful, because I haven't checked this. I didn't know this was over here. I think...
I welcome you, friend. How may I serve?
Welcome to you too, Madron. Show me what you got for sale.
Take a look.
I think that Hjolfrid knows now more than ever that there is another player on this chess field. By that I mean the Divines. I think that she has been too lucky in too many situations not to kind of feel this presence. And I think now more than ever she's starting to understand that, like I said, something is up here and someone has an active vested interest in maybe not keeping her alive necessarily, but perhaps guiding her through the means of keeping herself alive. Now that she understands that there's this dragon threat looming and she understands the severity of it, I think she's more focused than ever on following through on these inklings of understanding at the fringes of her mind. Ooh, cooking pot. Need that. And I think what she's thinking is that, nothing has changed in terms of the College of Winterhold being the strongest lead that she has on answers. But I think now also, since she's seen firsthand what kind of threat looms, I think that she also is banking on the College of Winterhold being perhaps a strong enough bastion of power to withstand such a terrible force. And so I think we're going to refocus our efforts on, you know, strengthening the College of Winterhold and making ourselves a part of it and utilizing it in the best way we can. We also have our good buddy Jazargo here, who has been a great friend and a loyal companion to us, and we're both simply students of the College of Winterhold. So if students of the College of Winterhold can withstand such trauma and such events, then perhaps there's something to be gained, you know, from allying. We're gonna really honestly need all the friends we can get if we're gonna have a hope of keeping this world alive. Is kind of where I'm thinking about it, where I think she would think about it. To that end, what I'm going to try and do right now is, if you remember, we have that quest. We have that quest to... Oh, Snaver Cat Soap Pelts. They're too expensive, though. To rescue some potential students, some missing apprentices from the college. So I think that we're going to go ahead and concern ourselves with that right now, simply because of, you know, how much help we're going to need. Like I said, it definitely feels to me like this playthrough now has a much more somber kind of feel to it, you know, after the events that we witnessed in the past couple episodes. It's also exciting because I feel like we have a very strong thematic direction. I think that Hjolfrid knows at this point. I don't think she understands exactly what it is to be dragonborn, or even if she believes that that's the case yet. But I think she knows somewhere in her heart that her fate is intertwined with what's been going on, and that she is part of the larger part of this, which also fuels that sort of realization that perhaps there is another unseen guiding hand in this whole debacle, who we theorize as Arkay. I don't really know if she's at that point yet, but I think her... Oh my god. All right, boy, bring it. Boom. That's what I'm talking about. I get him? Oh yeah, he's done. Oh, it's so loud. I think just what else could it be, you know? I think that those tangents on the edge of her mind are getting stronger and stronger, and soon we'll reach higher understanding. But for now, we focus on one thing at a time, and our current task is to rescue these missing college students so that we can bolster our numbers and, you know, hopefully stand a chance against this dragon threat that looms. It's a pretty exciting time to be alive, to be honest, in this world of Hjolfrid. Also, I gotta tell you guys, the past couple episodes, all in the comments, have been so much fun for me to read your guys' reactions to everything that's been going on and to hear your take on how Hjolfrid would feel about like these certain situations. It really, really is a pleasure for me to see how engaged you guys are with the series. It really fills my heart. So thank you for that, and I hope that you are enjoying it as much as many of you seem to be. So I know these college apprentices are supposed to be here. Let's check the map. I think they're, yeah, this is them. So 1, 2, 3, 4? All right, 4. That's what we're working with. I've never done this quest before. I think it's Immersive College of Winterhold. I'm pretty sure, but I'm not 100% sure, because like I said, I've never done it. So we'll just have to see, and we'll be careful, because I don't know what's awaiting us, and that's always dangerous. The other thing that I wanted to bring up, ooh, yikes, is that in the interest of furthering the college quest line, what I would like to do after this... Ooh, what's going on here? Ooh. Oh, it's Imperials fighting out, probably just a bandit. Anyway, you guys are deep behind enemy lines. I don't know if I want to be near you. Fights are going to break out. But anyway, what was I saying? Lost my train of thought. Oh, yeah. After we see about these apprentices... Looks like I'm hungry. I'm going to go ahead and give myself something to eat here. Carrot. No, that's not gonna do. How about some Horker stew? I don't have any stamina buffs either. Oh, that's the other thing, is I should probably... Here, let's go ahead and, take a quick... Oh, there's a wolf. That was perhaps not the best time to dismount. Here we go. Bring it, then. Don't attack my horse. Oh, boom, baby! Warhammer of Inebriation is degraded in quality. It's still pretty good, though. Our boots aren't doing so hot. That's not good. We're gonna have to see about that. Go ahead and take a wolf heart. Sure, why not? I need to make a kind of a fire stop here. I'm getting cold. What was I going to say? I keep losing my train of thought. Oh, yeah. The thing that I would like to do after we rescue these apprentices, or at least attempt to. Oh, yeah, we're getting real cold. Shit. Well, here's a little marker. Is there something? Oh, we can take shelter in here for perhaps just a moment. Stillborn cave. Doesn't look like this could be too dangerous. Well, let's get our weapon out just in case. Once again, sidetracked. What I would like to do after we hopefully rescue these apprentices is Felglow Keep, which is the next thing for us to do in the college quest line. It's so loud in here. And it's going to be really tough because it's a whole thing full of mages. And, oh, it's much better. It's a whole fort full of mages, and if we're going to have any hope of taking them down, we're really going to need some resistance. So off camera, in between the last episode and this one, I tried to get a lot of stuff done. I ran a lot of errands, sold off some stuff, and purchased a couple resistance potions that hopefully will help us once it comes time to take on Felglow Keep. I'm also probably going to go beforehand and pick up Lydia. Hey, can you get out of the way, Jazargo? I'm sorry. Pick up Lydia as a follower. I've balanced Ultimate Skyrim so that it's supposed to be balanced around, you know, having two followers. But really, you can have as many as you want. The only restriction is yourself, however you want to do it. I don't really like playing with any more than two, because then I think it kind of cheapens some things. But I like playing with two followers because it has kind of like that party feel that can be a lot of fun. But I'm going to go and pick up Lydia as a housecarl and really just kind of assess the damage to Whiterun. And, you know, my fingers are crossed that it's not too terrible, you know. Here we go. Add fuel, books, branches to kindling. We don't really have much of anything. Let's see what we have on Cinnamon, because I basically swapped out her whole inventory with Ingrid's. We have some firewood. We should be fine. I think I have a branch. Oh, maybe not. No books either. Oh, well. Use campfire. Use kindling for the build fuel, or build fire, add fuel. I don't want to use my lantern oil. What do we need? Add tinder. We need wood shavings. Sure. This is difficult to light under current conditions. That's okay. So that's my plan. Jazargo, my friend, can you, kind of migrate yourself somewhere a little bit different? I also gave Jazargo the pale blade so that he'd be able to defend himself in, circumstances where he needs an actual weapon, because I neglected to do that before. And that's kind of where we're at. Like I said, it feels like a much more sober playthrough at this point, just given the raised stakes. But it's also a lot more fun that way, you know, because now suddenly it's like, ooh, there's a lot more at stake with every move that we choose to make. See, crackling campfire, some dead wood, firewood. I don't have enough for that. Hopefully this is enough to warm us up. Jazargo and me camping out by the fire. Hopefully nothing else comes to get us in the meantime. I'm really proud to be traveling with our friend Jazargo here. It's really insane. Think about how many people would stick with us, you know, after witnessing, or even who would follow us into a fight like the one that we just experienced. I think that's absolutely insane, you know? I think that it kind of stands to the loyalty and potential of the members of the college, and I think it's a big part of the reason why Hjolfrid is betting so strongly on the college. At least that's how I theorize it. All right, I think that's good. Let's be on our way, my friend. Back out into the cold. Oh, and that does look cold. I really like the way that looks. All right. You're going to have to be careful because we are operating in the frigid, frozen north. Probably it would be best to grab some snowberries. I think I have some on cinnamon, but I don't think a whole lot. So the reason that we need snowberries, by the way.
The cave. I don't think there are warm fires and friendly faces inside.
Perhaps not. Well, at least we know there's one warm fire. Am I right, my friend? Ha ha ha. Oh, I'm kind of hurt. I'm regenerating health. Here, let's do this. Let's go ahead and put on our aura. And just do it this way. Where is my healing aura? Healing aura right here. Thank you. Oh, wow. When we're not wearing all of our armor and stuff, that really works very well. So I noticed something. One of you guys pointed out that when I'm using my equip sets, my boots aren't being equipped. And this is not because of an error on the equip set. It's actually because of a limitation of like Sky UI. I realized this, and so if you guys ever encounter this in your game, here's like kind of the halfway solution. There really is no solution. But because for my mage equip set, I have this noble fur line boots, something about the fact that it contains the word boots and the fact that my hedge knight boots also contain the word boots makes them, they won't swap out. They won't equip like the boots. So just something to be mindful of going into the future. For any of you guys on your playthroughs, if you like using, you know, the equip sets and so on and so forth. All right, moving on up. But yes, I kind of interrupted myself with the snowberries. If you ever need to kind of operate in the frozen north over here, or you need to go into the water specifically, you're going to need snowberries. In fact, there's a lot of them around. So how about we just go ahead and hop off our horse and just have her follow us. And then we'll just pick some of this stuff up on foot. But you can use these snowberries to create an extract. Oh, that's more than enough right there. There you go. That's also going to be nerfed as well. This is one of the ways in which... What happened? Jazargo. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Jesus Christ. Fuck off, mate. Why are you using that bow? Oh, there you go. Much better. Oh, he's running. Anyway, what was I saying? One of the ways in which Requiem is kind of... Oh, he's just using it because it's far enough away to where you can't hit it with this magic. I suppose that makes sense. One of the ways that Requiem's alchemy is a little bit overpowered is that you gain a ton of alchemical ingredients for every harvest node. And he's close. It's like whatever this is what we're looking for. And as part of the wonderful Behind the Curtain overhaul, which has since been updated since the version that we're running in this configuration, that will be fixed as part of his overhaul. Part of Zeromorph is the wonderful, wonderful guy who created that mod, and it's really a fantastic mod if you've never seen it before. Hey, Jazargo, where are you? Oh, that is not my friend, I don't think. Or maybe it is. Oh, no, he's not. What was that? Did you guys hear that sound? Oh, my God. Stop. What is that? Holy shit. Hold on, take cover. Oh, my God. Anyone else in here? Oh, it looks like some sort of little... Oh, it's a skeever. Gross. Come on, then. Bring it, bitch. I think he's afraid of me. Oh. Oh, where's Jazargo? I think I heard him. I think that's Jazargo. Yeah, that's my boy. Here, Jazargo, you want the honors? Yeah, roast it. Oh, through the window, too, with style and panache, my friend. Oh, I'm getting a little bit thirsty here. There we go. Oh, that sounds like a wolf. Hmm. Oh, 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 it is a wolf. You gonna take him on, Jazargo? Oh, it's a dog. Hey, buddy. What are you running from? Are you just taking shelter from the cold? Well, don't worry about it. You can hang out in here with us. No worry. Maybe he's scared of whatever that explosion sound was out front. I'm kind of scared of that, to be honest. Kind of peek out over here. I don't see anything or hear anything directly around us. That doesn't mean nothing's there, of course. Anyway, ooh. I got potion of featherweight. Well, where's our guy? That wasn't our guy out front. Where's a... Oh, shit. Oh, hello, Borvir. Oh, no, this is our guy. Ah, what a shame. Perhaps he had potential, I'll never know. Well, it looks like we're still... Oh, we need his dagger. I guess that's... We need proof that he's died. Roasted goat leg, that could be good to have. Coin purse, roll of paper, probably just to keep as a kindling, potentially. Sure, why not some bread? Oh! Oh, the dog, you keep scaring me, buddy. This is a kind of a convenient little place to hide out. We need to remember that this is here. Oh, why is this apothecary's satchel floating in the air? Ooh, garlic and glow dust, not bad. What we got here? Herbalist guide to Skyrim. Maybe we'll get some alchemy experience. Agnetophalia, don't we know that person? That sounds very familiar to me. Potion of Magicka, why not? Got a bucket. A barrel. Juniper berries, that's always good. What we got in here? Honeycomb? Not bad. Let's see. Search barrel. More juniper berries. This kind of seems like a little... Ooh, staff of soul trapping. So we're not probably going to use that because of this Arcay business. I think a fair compromise. We were talking about how Arcay's law prevents us from... Oh, man. Look at all these alchemical ingredients. There's a bunch of these fish who I haven't messed with yet. But Arcay's law kind of prevents us from trapping souls ourselves. I think that the kind of workaround that we're going to use for that, I think Arcay would understand that in these dire times, hey, gold necklace, not bad. Ooh, and a treasure map. In these dire times, we would kind of need to use...
The desert. The north wind chills us to the bones.
Absolutely, Jizargo. Maybe utilizing souls that have already been trapped could be seen as a form of release, but we won't trap any souls ourselves, I think is a fair compromise. Jizargo, he's already got full face gear and hood and cloak. Gayleg, what do you have for me, my friend? Let's see. How's our exposure? It's getting not that bad because we just kind of camped out in that little place. Well, how far away is... looks like it's close enough. I'm just going to go on foot. Cinnamon! Cinnamon Ho! Just go ahead and wipe back over there where you're nice and safe. Oh my god, Wismothers! Holy shit! Holy crap! Well, perhaps only one Wisp Mother, and maybe the rest of those are her shades, but I'm not fucking with any of them. Holy Jesus, looks like they killed something. Is that like a, that's not what I wanted. Where's my, telescope? Whoa. Oh, they did, they killed a bear. Look at these fucking, yikes. Terrifying. Ah, it's so bright. Well, we are not fucking around with them, that's for sure. But yeah, so we're going to go and take on Felglow Keep after this, or at least that's the plan. Lydia will hopefully help us with that, and it'll be good to have another member of our party. I always think it's, and this is kind of like the reason why I balanced Ultimate Skyrim around having a maximum of 2 followers. Having followers is a lot of fun. It can really kind of inform, like, the, you know, relationships that you have, like, with these characters and with your own character. And there's also distinct advantages and disadvantages to having followers. Obviously, it's like if you have even one follower, you can't really stealth in any way. I don't think I'm going to be able to bash this, but I figure it's worth a shot. I can't even really hit it. Ooh, skeleton. Bone meal. That makes sense that you would have that. Ooh, soothe, huh? What does that do? Let's see. Soothe. Illusion. Exposure is reduced by 20 for 30 seconds. Ah. It is a, thing to help us survive in the cold. Perhaps good to have. I might use that later. But anyway, there are definite advantages and disadvantages to either having followers or going by yourself. The disadvantages are pretty obvious, is that you don't have a buddy to watch your back. But the advantages is, like, you can stealth. It's really hard to stealth with a follower character, or unless your follower character is stealthy themselves, and even then it can be a little bit tricky. I don't know, it's just fun stuff for you to play with. And far be it for me to tell you guys how to play your game. You know, within restriction, obviously, like I said, I've balanced it around a certain experience. But, okay, I think that's where we're going. Okay. Look, a rabbit. A rabbit! Alright, here's what we got. Leather case, telescope. Okay, what do we have here? Is a pillar and a bowl of some... Oh, you know what? I've been here before. Actually, this place killed me one time during my playtesting. If this is the same place I'm thinking of, which I'm like 99% sure, there's like a bunch of frost runes on the ground right next to it. And it's really hard to spot them, so it's like a very dangerous little spot. Because I don't think I was on like a quest or anything when I did this the first time. I was just kind of like wandering around. And I stepped on one, and it scared the bejesus out of me. So what was I going to... There's something else I want... Oh, yeah. So in the meantime, one of our other kind of tertiary goals, you could say, is to replace our silver weapon, our silver sword. And I think this time around, I'm either going to buy or... Ooh, I'm starting to get cold. I'm either going to buy or purchase axe, silver battle axe, because it's more effective against undead. Chopping... Here, let's see. We go real slow. Oh, I can see one already. It's right there. Okay, there's one, and see, and then, oh, there's another one, I think. I can't really tell. I'm not super eager to get close. Well, now we have Unrelenting Force, so we can just clear these out. But anyway, yeah, the battle axe is more effective against undead, because, here we go, boom. Oh, yeah, there was another one. I saw another one explode. Anyway, ooh, there's a staff. The battle axe is more effective against undead because undead have pretty gnarly resistances to venom of a spider. What else we got? Lesser soul. Well, where's our apprentice? Is this where it's telling us to go? Yeah. Oh, it's the dagger. Rundi's dagger. He must have not made it as well. Anyway, undead. I always get so distracted. Frost Miriam. Rundi's. Stop pushing me, asshole. Rundi's dagger. Silver bowl. The undead are more resistant to, any kind of attack that's designed to mess with vital organs or intended to bleed. So like swords and arrows are really useless against them. But and they actually also have resistance to blunt weapons, I believe. That's another frost rune, I think. Can you guys see that? It looks like a slight blue tint. Here, hold on a second. Here, let me be very careful. Is that? I can't tell. Here, I'm gonna hit it just in case. Oh my god! Oh, it was! Hey, there you go. That's how we learn. Anyway, keep getting distracted. That's the problem with undead. Staff of Ice Spikes, I'll take it. Shit, we need to get inside. Let's make our way over to Winterhold and, well, where's my horse? Oh, whoops. That's not what I wanted to do. But yeah, it's hard to hit undead with blunt weapons, with bladed weapons, or with arrows because they don't have any vital organs, they don't bleed. Why are you running all weird? The best way to take them out is axes, chopping weapons, which I guess is supposed to simulate the effectiveness of like chopping off limbs, even though you can't do that, obviously, in Skyrim, or at least not without mods. But I think it's a pretty cool little dichotomy, you know, where, I mean, this is one of like the things that's most awesome about Requiem, in my opinion. Is how it really, really tries to differentiate the different weapons from each other. And not even just different weapons, but different styles of attacking. And, I need to shut up and move faster here. Different styles of attacking, different styles of combat. It really aims to make them, or at least by my interpretation, it really aims to make them feel very different from each other. And I appreciate that quite a bit because I think that's a problem that vanilla Skyrim has. Where everything kind of eventually feels the same. All right, let's get... Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Bright light mode. That's, if you guys didn't know what that is, if you run expanded towns and cities, you can adjust the lighting amount with those chains. Welcome. That are kind of like seamlessly added. If you want to. Thank you. Oh, that was actually kind of close. Ooh, boy. So get nice and warm. We will go and check out this third boy, this third guy who we're supposed to rescue. I'm beginning to think that none of the three of them are going to still be alive, which is not fantastic for our whole bolstering the strength of the College of Winterhold scenario. What you doing over there, Gisargo? Here.
Khajiit got your back.
Yeah. I'm really thankful for you. Really, I am.
There is much for Gisargo to be sure of. There is skill in magic, there is charm, and there is a strong will. Gisargo will be successful. Of this there is no doubt.
Aw, he's so cute. I love him.
Khajiit will follow.
Gisargo, I'll be successful. Aw, was I seriously not losing exposure while I did that? Alright, well, hurry up then. Come on. That's one thing I kind of wish would go faster, is it's like, if I'm inside and I'm getting warm and whatever, I don't see the need for the meter to go down little by little. It's also very possible that that might be changed in the version that we'll be playing with for the beta release version and season two. Because Frostfall has since been updated to a new version that has a very different system for how it manages like its exposures and like exposure limits. So I'm very excited to play with that. Hey, love. Come on over. Come on, Cinnamon. All right, let's go ahead and jump back on. And I don't know where this third one is. It might be farther away. Let's check our map real fast. Oh, there's four of them. That's right. All right, well, shit. This is what we're going to need those snowberries for. Here, I'm going to pick up some more. Just in case. Give me that. And give me... Here, follow me on foot. Follow me on foot, mine love. Oh, have I already picked these? Not these ones. Nuh-uh. Ooh, these ones are nice and green. Not even covered in snow. So, let's go ahead and I'm looking for create item. And do this, and then I'm going to create some snowberry extract. Create two of them, actually. There we go. Now we can traverse the frigid waters. Oh, it looks like I'm a little hungry as well. Let's go ahead and pop a cabbage soup. That sounds pretty gross, actually. Zargos consume roasted goat leg. As long as you're nice and, what's the word? Satiated, Jazargo. So we're going out this way. I'm still going to get on my horse because it's cold. And this will go faster. We got to be careful, though, going down these sheer cliffs. It can be very dangerous. Sometimes the horse will catch an edge, so to speak. And suddenly you find yourself flying off the edge of the cliff. And really, like, falling damage, that's another thing about Requiem, is that falling damage is very intense relative to the vanilla game. I don't know if that also applies to horses. I think it does. But I know that they can't withstand too gnarly of a fall. This kind of sucks. Is there a way for me to get across over here without going in the water? Oh, Horker. Oh, boy. I might be able to do it here. All right, well, looks like I'm going to leave my horse behind. Just for now. Those horkers aren't trying to come get me, are they? I think they are. Oh, it is trying to get me. Alright, horse, run away. Here, we'll get some, two-handed practice. Come on. Oh, there he goes. Boom. He's running. Are you going for my horse? Oh, they are. Come on. Cinnamon. Come on. You fucking idiot. Thank you. Stay away from my horse, you horker assholes. This is kind of hilarious, actually. Here, check this out. Wait, here. I almost got hit. I'm not trying to... No, I'm trying to do this. I'm trying to use my unrelenting force. There we go. Whoa. Oh, Jesus, Jazargo, you scared the shit out of me again. Oh. Oh, that one was tough. I had to brain him, like, twice. Looks like they're running. Yeah, leave... Oh, look, he's still going. Get him! Take pot shots. It's good practice, I'm sure. It's not bad with a bow, actually. I missed that time. I guess I spoke too soon. What do you got for me, Horker? Horker fat? That's pretty useful, I suppose. We can use the meat to make Horker stew. That's always useful. What about the tusks? Yeah, they're not that useful. Look at that. Horker, fat, and then meat. All right, and then we are on our way. Hey, Jazargo, really? Come on, man. Fine, go have your fun. I'm going to pop my snowberry extract and go do our actual job. That's okay. It's all part of his personality, you know? I'm looking for air. Potions. Snowberry extract. There we are. And now we are safe to traverse this frozen water if we fall in. Which, hopefully we will not, but, you know, oh. Almost did there. Ooh, look how nice and reflective the ice is. How cool. Pretty. I don't know. Oh, look at Jazargo. He's just like off murdering horkers. That's hilarious. What time is it right now? 4:13 p.m. I got some wolves hunting some horkers as well, looks like. Okay, well, there's some kind of ruin over here, so we do have to be... Oh, Jesus Christ. Good thing I turned when I did. Ice wolf. Give me that wolf heart. I don't really care much for the pelts. There's a structure over here, most definitely. Jazargo, I'm going to need you with me, buddy. Where are you? Here, I'm going to summon him. Leader's teleportation. There he is.
There?
He's not just gonna run and get the porker, is he? Bro, where are you going? Whatever. He's fine. Okay, this looks almost like a dragon burial. Oh no, it's not a dragon burial mound. Here, let's sneak up, see what we can hear. Is this it? I don't even think this is it. What is this? Oh, it's Yzgrimor's tomb! Oh shit, whoa, this is for the, companions. We don't need to be here. Although good to know that it's here, I suppose. Uh-oh, Snowy Sabercat. Hey boy, we need your pelt. Anyone else? Bring it on. Let's do it. How's my durability? Pretty decent on some of my equipment. Not on all. Alright, bring it on.
You're dead.
Oh. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to... God damn, I keep forgetting I'm switching my powers. Oh, he's hurting me. Unrelenting force. Ow, 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 what the hell? Whoa, he knocked me down. God damn it. Ugh. God, I hate how effective these things are at killing me, even when I'm... Oh, Jazargo, did you save my ass? Or did you... Oh. Ugh, God. Oh, my God. Jazargo, I fucking owe you hardcore. See, that's what happens when you get cocky, man. That's exactly what happened. Was that another one that I heard? I got cocky. I got knocked down. I almost got myself killed for it. But Jazargo had our back. One of the benefits of having a follower. Snow pelt. I mean, I'll take the rest of this, too. Heart and teeth. Oh, yep, here comes Cinnamon. Are you being chased by horkers? What the heck's going on here? Oh, looks like they are coming. Just moving right along. Here, come on, let's go kill them. I mean, you're getting out of here. You're afraid of horkers, but not a saber cat? How does that make any... Ooh, clams. What'd you got? Clam meat? Maybe a pearl for me? Stay away from my horse, you fucking assholes. That really doesn't seem to do anything. Oh, roasted horker. Oh, nice work. Dude, Jazargo is just fucking killing it lately. He's like the best. He saved us from a saber cat. He's taking down horkers left and right. Pretty good stuff. Oh, this must be it over there. All right, well, it looks to be about that time. So we'll see. Oh, wait. Here. Let's just, last thing I'm going to do is just kind of check in here, peek in with our telescope, see what we're dealing with. I see a bunch of skeevers, a cage that's open. A shrine of Talos, is that what that is? I mean, that is. I don't know, down below it, I think so. Well, we'll get a closer look in the next episode. So as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.